right, so now we go into the topic tropospheric aerosols. Now, atmospheric aerosols are in opposed to atmospheric gases or tropospheric gases. Atmospheric aerosols are suspensions of small solid and or liquid particles. So the keyword here is particles, and these particles exist in the atmosphere, and since it's a particle, there is a fall speed to them or settling speed to them, but here atmospheric aerosols are categorized as particles with negligible terminal fall speeds. That means the falling speeds of these particles can be considered as zero, which means that they will be suspended in the atmosphere. Now, there are four sources of atmospheric aerosols, or these particles with negligible terminal fall speeds, and they are from the biological sources. They could also come from the solid earth. Some anthropogenic or human-related emissions would also release or be a source for them, and they can also be formed in the atmosphere through in-situ formation. Now, on the right, you see a diagram that categorizes the different types of atmospheric aerosols with different particle diameter values going from 0.0001 micrometer at 10 to the power of negative 4 up to 10 to the power of 3 or 1000 micrometer. Now, the small ions and so on are within this range from 10 to the power of negative 4 until 10 to the power of negative 3. And maybe this is something that we would be interested in because it's related to the topic that we are delving into right now, which is air chemistry. And the ranges of these tropospheric aerosols go from very small, from 10 to the power of negative 3 up to 10 to the power of 1 or more. Just for comparison, you see cloud and precipitation. The particles in that that category goes from 10 to the power of negative 2 until 10 to the power of 3. Now we talk about the individual four sources. Individual sources from, as mentioned, the previous slide. Now we talk about the biological sources. The first one that we'll discuss. So solid and liquid particles are released into the atmosphere from plants and animals in the form of seeds, pollen, spores, fragments of animals and plants. And the ranges of particles released by these biological sources go from 1 to 250 micrometers. So if you refer back to this diagram, so from 1, which is somewhere from here, until 250 up to here. So this is the range of particle size coming from biological sources. And the biological sources come from oceans as well as forests, or specifically forest fires. Now, oceans are major sources of these atmospheric aerosols. They're released in the form of sea salts. And when they are in the form of sea salts, they are very large particles. And these sea salts are emitted into the atmosphere through the process called bubble bursting. And the sea salts are known as hygroscopic salts. And the types of hygroscopic salts are the sodium chloride, potassium chloride, calcium sulfate, ammonium sulfate. And the ones that releases this, there are also some other atmospheric aerosols released from organic compounds and as well as bacteria. And this could also include those sulfur compounds or the sulfur dioxide, the precursor of sulfur dioxide gas. Then there's the forest fire source, which are also major sources of aerosol, and they can release small smoke particles in the form of organic compounds, even elemental or carbon in the form of carbon atoms, and also fly ash. But the sizes are quite small at 0.1 micrometer, and if you refer back to the diagram before, 0.1 is somewhere in the middle of this range. Now we go into the next source of tropospheric aerosol, which is the anthropogenic source. Now, the global input of particles in the atmosphere from anthropogenic activities is about 20% by mass of that from natural source. Now, the sources of anthropogenic anthropogenic emissions are dust from roads, wind erosion of tilted land, even biomass burning, fuel combustion, and industrial processes. We can categorize the anthropogenic emissions in the form of tropospheric aerosol into two main categories. One are for particles that are more than 5 micrometers, and usually this more than 5 micrometers particles come from direct emissions, which means that they are released in the already in that size range. And there's also the particles that which are less than 5 micrometers, and these particles would be formed in the atmosphere through conversion processes. Another type of tropospheric aerosol source is the in-situ formation, or tropospheric aerosols that are created in the atmosphere in-situ. In-situ condensation of gases, or the accumulation or the coagulation of these gases into larger particles in the atmosphere, creates these tropospheric aerosols, and this process increases the mass of the particle, which forms new particles. But these particles are of small size, of less than 0.0 micrometer. And the major chemical species that can form in the atmosphere in situ are the sulfur gases, the nitrogen gases or aerosols, organic material, as well as carbonaceous material or material that contains carbon. Sulfur gases can be oxidized into sulfur dioxide, because there are other types of gases that contain sulfur that's emitted from the earth or from biological processes, such as dimethyl sulfide, carbonyl sulfide, hydrogen sulfide, and so on. They can be oxidized into sulfur dioxide, which then can also turn into sulfate ions. From the ocean, sulfate ions comes from the dimethyl sulfide gases, which are emitted from biological sources. Now we talk about the chemical composition of the tropospheric aerosols. Now, sulfate ion is one of the prime contributors of the mass of atmospheric aerosols, and over the oceans, the contributor is from marine aerosols. And one example is the sodium chloride aerosol. So sulfate ions comes from gas to particle conversion, which means that it is originally a gas and it converts to particle. And these things comes from the sulfur dioxide gas. The source of sulfate from the continental side of the earth is ammonium ions, which is associated with the sulfate ions as well. Over the ocean, there are emissions of sodium ions, chloride ions, magnesium ions, sulfate ions, potassium ions, and so on, and calcium ions.